So hi everyone, a very good evening to you all. Thank you so much for joining us today to celebrate Wildlife Week. Today's webinar is brought to you by Wildlife SOS in collaboration with Bombay Natural History Society. My name is Sandeep Priya. I am the Deputy Director, Corporate and Philanthropic Partnership at Wildlife SOS. I'll be your moderator for the day. We'll be talking about reptile conservation in India and why it is critical to conserve reptiles. I would now like to introduce you all to our speaker for this webinar, Mr. Baijuraj MB. Mr. Baijuraj is an expert herpetologist and director of conservation projects at Wildlife SOS. He'll be sharing with us all his knowledge about reptiles and insights on rescuing reptiles from distressing situations in urban habitats. Over to you, Baiju sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Sandy. Let me just share my presentation. Can you all see my presentation?
Visible.
Okay. So, good evening, everybody. We'll be talking about some reptiles, not all, because we are
Baiju sir?
I think we'll wait for another minute. I think there is a problem at his network, with his network. Let's just give it a minute. All of you to please be with us. We'll be just back in a minute or so. There is some technical problem. Thank you. Yes, Mr. Baijuraj is back with us.
He's just joining.
Sorry.
No problems at all.
Sorry for that. Something had fallen on our transformer because we are inside a sanctuary. Some tree or something, because of wind, it's fallen on our transformer and power failure happened. Sorry for that. So what I was talking, can you hear me, Sandi, now?
Yes, sir. You're very much audible.
Okay. So when we talk about acknowledgement, we want to acknowledge all these departments, and with their support, we really work in this field, because As we are all aware about Wildlife Protection Act and what you call species coming under different schedules, we are not supposed to hold or keep in captivity or rescue or anything of any of these wild animals. So what we always require is permissions. Permissions to work in different states have to be given by different departments and different state forest department. So we acknowledge all these people because we are happy and proud to say because of their support, forest department support, MOEF CC support and Central Zoo Authority support, we are able to work in this field and help many more animals. So when we talk about snake-human interaction, it is one of the major interactions going on in the country today, because if a tiger or a leopard stray into the human habitation, it is very, very, very few cases happening. But when we talk about snakes, what happens is they are every day throughout the country, we can see, if you look at the southern part of India, the whole year you can see snake encounters. But if you look at northern part of India, we get we have a monsoon season. It is more concentrated snake-human interaction. And in extreme winters, we don't get much snakes. And in extreme hot also, we don't get much snakes. So that is the condition. And if you look at the data, 58,000, that is actually in an hashtag, because 58,000 is only a reported study, reported which had been reported. 58,000 people die every year in India because of snake bite. So why? This is only because of negligence. We'll talk about that in detail, because World Health Organization has already declared it as a neglected tropical disease. Because of negligence, many of the people or children or grown-ups or whatever, everybody die because of that. Because if you go on a timely manner to a hospital, you can always be saved. And in our state where we work, Uttar Pradesh, itself is 8,700 deaths are reported every year. And this is, as again and again, I wanted to mention, it is only reported to the hospital deaths. It is much higher than this reports, because even in my case, I know last week also, last month also, we had many calls. They had not even gone to hospital. So this case are not even reported. So that is one major issue. So when we talk about some of the common snakes, because it's a big presentation, I don't want the audience to be bored off. So I'll be going little quick in today's presentation, because we have three parts to cover, that is monitor lizard as well as crocodiles. So when we talk about some of the common snakes, we have Indian rock python, we have black-headed royal snake, we have rat snake. Rat snake is one of the interesting species we talk about, because rat snakes are the best friend, considered as the best friend of farmers. So that is what it is known as, because thousands and thousands of tons of grains are being wasted or spoiled by the rats, and the snakes are very, very helpful in controlling this pest, the rats. When we talk about other species which we normally or commonly get here or rescue here, are common kukri, red sand boa and common sand boa. So red sand boa and common sand boa are almost similar, but both lives mostly under the sand or burrows or mud. So why they are called? Because they have their head is very sharp, and then they can easily dig into the mud. Then we come to common bull snake. Common bull snake are one of the one of the snake which had been very, very common, very, very largely killed snake, thinking of crate. So misinterpreting that this is crate and it is highly poisonous. And then that's why it is being killed in the cities, because it is a nocturnal snake, same as like crate. And most of the time it is coming into human habitation, like crevices, cracks and other areas. Then we talk about mildly venomous snakes. When we talk about the whole about the snakes, we have non-venomous snakes, venomous snakes, and mildly venomous snakes. So when we talk about mildly venomous snakes, they have rare fangs. which cannot, like, they cannot bite human beings or us, and they can only bite or sedate, like, what you call lizards or small crickets and other small animals. So that's why they have they are mildly venomous, and they are having rare fangs, because if you give the hand, they cannot bite us, because it has to, the finger or the finger have to really go inside. So then only will the venom will be injected. And the left side is a cat snake, and the right side is an ornate flying snake. Actually, the flying snakes are not found in Uttar Pradesh. It is in Eastern Ghats and Western Ghats. But we got this from a snake charmer, because these are one of the major issues, that the snakes are displaced here, carried everywhere throughout the country by the snake charmers and the poachers and other people who do an illegal trade on these species. When we talk about India, we have we talked about venomous, sorry, non-venomous and mildly venomous. Now we talk about venomous. These are the big four we considered. We call as big four because cobra, common crate, Russell's viper, and saw-scaled viper. In this area in Agra, we get only crate and crate and cobra. But if you move little towards Itawa and Ba area, we also get Russell's viper. And saw-scaled viper, we don't get at all here in this area. Rajasthan, we find the saw-scaled viper, and from Maharashtra down, we get a large number of saw-scaled vipers. And sometimes when we tell black snake with white band, these are crates. So when you get a small snake, what do you do? So you don't understand. So to identify a crate, is it a crate or a wolf snake? We only have to look at its face, because we don't want to talk it scientifically, scale counting or all these things to a normal person. So normal person, how we explain is, if you look at crate, the face, the front head will be like our index finger. It will be like round in shape. And if you talk about wolf snake, the head will be exactly like a cutoff. So these are the difference between a wolf snake and a crate, you have to always understand. But these both are crate. This is a crate baby snakelet, the left-hand side photo, and the right side is a fully adult crate. And if you look at small baby of a black-headed royal snake, it is like a snakelet. It is very different pattern or bands or whatever, blush marks. And if you look at an adult, royal snake, it is full of different mark and a beautiful snake, which we call its head will become purely black. So it is why that is known as black-headed royal snake, or diadem we also call. And then here we have checkered keelback. This is two different coloration you can see. Sometimes people will tell, okay, this photo, some books we see or the presentation we see, if it is only one color, people cannot understand whether it is a checkered keelback or it is some other species. So that is one of the other issues we face. So that's why we have to incorporate many pictures for one snake. And when we come to snake bite and precautions, we always have to remember, snakes only bite when we provoke the snake or when the snake is hurt. Otherwise, snakes don't come or run, chase you and bite. The cases are very, very, I don't know, it is, we can tell no. Many of the bites are by accident or wrong rescue. Many of our rescuers in the country are dying because of show off for the photography and because of social medias. They want to take pictures, they want to do all these acts, imitating TV shows. These are the problems of snake bites or accident snake bites, because if you don't have a proper equipment, snake bite can happen. No snake bite in revenge, I told you in before also. There is no bite recorded like it will come and bite you after 1 week or 1 month or 1 year, whatever it is. That is only in the serials and movies. No snakes follow you. They never follow anybody. So we don't have to worry about that as well. No snake come and bite you from far, because people always ask me if a snake is there in my house, what I should do to just put it outside. So I always tell them, make a hook, take a long stick and just lift it and put it outside. It will never bite you. We always have to think, because last 2 days before also we had a discussion. Some people were asking what is the distance it can jump. So you always have to think that if it is a 4 feet snake, it can back up and jump maximum to a 2 feet. More than that, it cannot jump. So you can always keep a distance. When we talk about precautions, what we have to do? If it is a snake prone area, first of all, you have to make sure it is a snake prone area. It is snakes are found, you are living in a jungle area or these areas, you should always use protective gear, footwear while walking out, and use flashlights. Please don't walk in the dark, because monsoon season, or maybe in the hot season, they want to come out in your garden to get a little cool because of their ectotherms. Avoid dark areas. Please don't put your hands in the dark areas where you had kept so many wood or something. There, the rats can make their home, and where rats are there, snakes will be always there to for food. Cautious while cleaning. You have to be always cautious while cleaning the rubbish and other areas, not with the hand, preferably. Know your snake prone area, which I told you before, because you don't have to become simply hyper or worry about the snakes, that it, always think snake. You can always think is it a snake prone area. You have to be careful. Do not disturb a snake. Wherever you see a snake, please contact forest department, inform them, and then call to the rescuer. If rescuers are not there, you can take your action accordingly. Do not disturb a snake. That is what, please don't disturb any snake if you see in your house. And the last is, do not imitate any TV shows if possible, because these are the cause of death today happening for many of the rescuers. What you should know, stay calm. Don't make the victim run or walk. Take him directly to hospital. And only the thing you can save a snake bite victim is the snake antivenom injection. If you don't get that, it is possibility of saving a victim is minimal. So what you have to do is go to a public health center or a nearby hospital where you can get injection, and the first dose itself will be a 10 vials. It is not like that one injection you can get, and it will be injected or implemented by a medical practitioner, MBBS doctor only. And when you talk about snake venom, this is what the same thing I was talking about. Snake venom is we have two types of snake venom, which is broadly classified into neurotoxin and hemotoxin. So we call cobra and crayed venom as neurotoxin, and we call Russell's viper and Soskale viper's venom as hemotoxins. So in India, we are lucky that we don't have to even worry about which snake had bitten you. You can just take the victim to the hospital. So if you have a cobra bite, crayed bite, Russell's viper bite, or a Soskale viper bite, you will be injected the same injection. So you don't have to worry about killing a snake, carrying it, or anything to the hospital. And coming to the snakes and law, we always have to keep in mind the rescuers or the people dealing with snakes. These are all, most of the snakes are protected under the Wildlife Protection Act. And you can see some of the pictures which I had taken from internet. This is the condition of snake rescues happening in India now. Many of the places, we have to show off, we have to put it in social media. So what we do is maximum, we somehow put a snake in the box or bottle or something where it rescues and put it. So what will happen to the snake? It's a living being. We have to release him. Once the rescue will be completed, only it is released. Otherwise, what will happen? This will not, the snake will not be released properly. It can go and die wherever you release. And also the people who handle snakes, unless and until they don't have a forest department permission, we always recommend not to handle snake, not to rescue snakes, or not to involve in the rescues, because you can get into trouble. Because many of these species are protected under Wildlife Protection Act. And also, you have to keep in mind, we always have to use proper rescue equipment. If you don't have a proper rescue equipment, you are inviting a chance of snake bite to you. So we always have to think that, please use a bag with a pipe, a good hook, And after bagging the snake, put it in a good box because snake can even bite from the bag as well. And then use also in last chance, use the tong as well. So you can see some of the snake rescues, a scientific method how we use. Some we are catching the snake because we have to take it from the bookshelf or somebody. Otherwise, we don't even have to catch the snake. This is some of the rescue. So you can see these videos. I'm just playing some of the videos. This is in a bed. So this was inside a bed. So you can imagine if this kind of a cobra is in the bed and if it is very, very dangerous. So you have to be very careful. This is what we call sometimes snake prone area. Snake can crawl into any place. You can see where all snakes go. This is a crate, and this was in a toilet commode. So what happened? We have to completely our rescuer have to completely take out the commode completely, and then we found the snake inside. So then rescue from the bathroom and bring release it in the wild. So these are some of the things really happening in the what you call as a result of urbanization or forest degradation and habitat degradation. This is inside a kitchen. See, it was also a 4 feet crate. So these are some of the things we have to always have to be careful. You have to be alert. Police booth near Taj Mahal. So it was inside. This was a rat snake. So a rat snake means we don't even need to worry about hook or something. We can simply lift the snake. It depends on how carefully you are handling. So This snake rescue, you can clearly see that it is not even the rescuer is touching the snake. You can see it is just diverting into that pipe and bag method. So we can easily rescue snakes like this. So you all know that snakes play a very crucial role in maintaining the rodent population. And that's why balancing the food chain. So we all have to always take care what good role the snakes are doing in the system. So we have to understand and we have to start living with the snakes. It is not necessary that every single snake have to be rescued and released in different area. So this is all about snakes. Then we go to monitor lizards. Some interesting fact about monitor lizard I'll be talking, and then we'll be going to the what we call crocodile species. So we have there are many species of crocodiles, around 75 to 80 species of crocodiles in the world. Monitor lizards in the world. So we 75 to 80 species of monitor lizards are found in the world, and we have 4 species, and we have a subspecies in Andaman. We are not talking about that. So the first is yellow monitor lizard. The second one is water monitor lizard, we call. These are all Varanus bengalensis. The third picture is Varanus bengalensis, which is the common monitor lizard found throughout the country, India. And the other one is Varanus grisus, which is found in the desert region, Rajasthan and other region. So this all comes under CITES Appendix 2 and IUCN least concern. The three species first, Varanus flavensis means this yellow monitor lizard, Varanus salvator water monitor lizard, and the Bengal monitor lizard. And Varanus grisus, the status is not till now completed, so it is not come under it, it had not put it in the category of IUCN, so it is still now not listed. These are the four species of monitor lizard we get in India, and this all four species are non-venomous. So when we look about them, so they don't have actually place to live now because of the habitat degradation, habitat fragmentation, habitat loss. They just roam, they just hide in anywhere, wherever they get a space to hide, because they are ectotherms, reptiles, and they can't cool down their body temperature or warm their body temperature. So they have to hide in place where it is in a normal temperature. So you can see the video, we get in the cooler. This is a cooler. Some people don't know, this is in front of a house. So it was in the cooler. It was hiding because of very, very hot, extreme hot weather. It was just going in the water and hiding there. It's only for a shelter, nothing else. It is not going to harm you anywhere. And one the next video, you can see it is hiding inside the hinge of a door. You can see that. It was just sitting there, and the owner saw that, and then we had to go and rescue. And till we reached, it took almost 1 hour to travel there. Then also the monitor lizard was still there only, because its motive, or its only it the idea or the what do you call, the motive of that animal was to only just hide. It's only a shelter. So what happens if you don't inform people working with the like rescuers or forest department? What happens to that? First is, if you don't take action, it is going to be killed because of fear and terror, because they don't know, because many people think this is a very, very dangerous monitor lizard. And then if you don't inform to a concerned authority, what happens next is people start rescuing it. Many people rescue it, and they sell it for meat, skin trade. These are all, you can see the photographs. It is skin, and that was that is like a killed monitor lizard. It was confiscated. They sell the monitor lizard for body parts, aphrodisiac, and black magic. These are the things happening in the country. Not if you look at talk about the country, it is widely this poaching and illegal trade is happening. This monitor lizard parts, body parts, you can see everywhere. It may be in Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, or northern India. Everywhere this monitor lizard's body parts are sold in the market. You can see this. It was confiscated in Mathura by Uttar Pradesh Forest Department. You can imagine this one piece is of one monitor lizard. So you can imagine how many monitor lizards have been killed for this many body part. And then these were many of them were injured. We confiscated many, so we could release them all back to wild, or freedom is the ultimate thing. And if an animal is rescued, we always considered releasing is the best possible thing which we can give to these animals. So they also play a very, very important role in the ecosystem. As I was telling about snakes, they do a lot of, many studies are there, like in West Bengal and all, they put some people throw the what you call chicken waste, and from the slaughterhouse waste, the monitor lizard just prey on them very in a large group, and they just feed on them. So they make the river clean along with the turtle. Turtle is also a reptile species. They, along with the turtle and these animals, make the city and the place clean. They are not any harmful to you. And they maintain this food chain. This is what we have to always be aware of. Awareness is very, very important to create because of these things. People think they come, they bite cattle and kill. All these things are, doesn't make any sense. These are all very, very important to our ecosystem. Then we come to crocodile species. Out of 22 species of crocodile around the world, we have 3 species in India. One is Gavialis gangeticus, that is known as Gadial in Hindi we call. And the other one is, middle one is saltwater crocodile or crocodile porosus. And the last photo, the right-hand side photo is crocodile palustris, which is mugger crocodile. We call mugger. So mugger is the crocodile people call mugger. So mugger is a English name. So it has become very common. Mugger ko mila, that it's a general term now. And the other one is Gadial, because of the pot in the snout, it is known as Gadial. So these are the 3 species we get in India. And like in 1972, when Wildlife Protection Act passed, and in 1973-74, when these species were protected, this all 3 species were critically endangered because of the poaching and skin trade, meat trade, and all these bags and other things we're making. These were a highly demand species, crocodiles and the skin. And that's why even crocodile, full crocodiles are sold, baby crocodiles are stuffed, are sold in many of the international markets. I have some pictures which I myself had taken in different countries. So these are the 3 species, and these 3 in 1973-74, these were completely critically endangered, these 3 species. Now, because of government's very good collaboration and the effort in 1974-77 onwards, this is still in critically endangered, the Gavialis gangeticus we call Gadial. And crocodile, saltwater crocodile had become least concerned, and the crocodile mugger crocodile has become the it is in vulnerable. So they had come up because of the protection which we had initiated, the government of India, and breeding, many of this breeding and introduction plan was sanctioned in 1977. And that is how this all species could at least survive. So what happened if you start excavating areas? This was a crocodile which we got. It was injured completely by a JCB because some excavation was going on. Unfortunately, this died. It was with us under treatment for almost a month, but we were feeding it forcefully. Then also the injury was very, very bad. The half of the snout, no snout, was completely broken and it couldn't survive. So this is the condition of rescue, some of the crocodile rescue. If you see, it can roam to anywhere. One was in the toilet, and some people tie and keep. This middle one is a Gavialis gangeticus gadial, and the right-hand side is a mugger. So what happens when people start taking actions like this? Most of the species may die because this is not like a rescue proper, fortunately these 2 had been very injured or any issue. We could even release then and there only after a minor complete observation and check in the cage. So these are the conditions of some of the rescues we do. So this is one released. You can see how fast a crocodile run. This was the same one which was tied and kept. So this is what we call a complete rescue. A rescue is only completed when the animal is released successfully in the wild or its natural habitat. And this was the same gadial, which was tied and kept. Luckily, it didn't have much injury, so we had to keep him little away and see the movement, whether it was able to go or any, we have to observe it, the motion, whether it was moving properly or any injury is there. So we had to keep it little away from the river and then release it into the river. So So this is why we wanted to show you this also, because these all calls, if you don't inform to forest department, or if you don't inform to a concerned authority or a local NGO working, what will happen is this all will go to markets like this. These are all from different countries in international markets. You can get a crocodile baby everywhere, stuffed and kept. You can get crocodile leathers, crocodile belts, crocodile purses, and also skulls available in many of the places. These are all pictures taken by myself, so from different countries. So these are the conditions we lose our species. So we have to always be careful. It is not only about India, throughout the world, wildlife crime or illegal trade is a very, very, very big issue, which is getting more and more, popular or unpopular, we can call. And it is, we have to be sensitized. We have to be aware about this species vanishing from our society or our ecosystem or our environment. So we all have to play our own role. So coming to the end of this webinar, we also wish you all should watch our shows. We have a Nat Geo Wild program, India's Jungle Heroes, how to rescue animals, proper rescue, how we had done proper rescues. All this we had shown properly in these episodes. It is available in Disney Hotstar as well, and it is easily everybody can watch anytime they want. 6 episodes were made of wildlife SOS with different rescues. And we also have a reptile page. You can always log in and like the page and share your pictures and ask many questions about reptiles and whichever you know or whichever you don't know, or which you know the knowledge, you can even share your knowledge in our page. And we also have different numbers for helpline in wildlife rescue. So we work throughout the country with along with forest departments of different states. So thank you for joining us today. Have a good day to all. And if you have any questions, please feel free to ask. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Beju sir, for an amazing webinar. And we will now move into the Q&A section. We have a few questions for you that people have sent prior to the webinar, as well as there are questions that the audience has sent during the webinar.
Okay. So somebody will ask, or I should read, Sandhi, how it is to be worked? Maima is going to ask.
Sir, I think Sandhi, we've lost Sandhi's network.
Okay. You can ask.
Right, sir. So the first question is, sir, how to differentiate between saltwater and freshwater crocodiles?
See, there are absence of ossi petal. That is the main difference we call. Because scientists, we look at that. There are many on the head, occipitals are absence in saltwater crocodile, and muggers it is present. So it is not about, if you are a common man, to identify it is very easy. It is not so easy. So what you have to first of all think it is, mugger crocodiles are broad snouted. The snout is broad, but saltwater crocodile snouts are long. One is that. So, and second thing, we have to always think where you are finding the species. So whenever somebody send me a photo, I will ask where you had got this, because I cannot also identify suddenly on looking at a photograph. So these are the conditions to see, first of all, to identify.
Thank you, Beju, sir.
First of all, the location is very important. And then we have to see whether it is overlapping. If you talk about like Uttar Pradesh or Chambal area, we can tell it is a mugger, because we don't get saltwater crocodile here. If you go to a little more eastern part, So we have to ask whether it, whether we have to see whether scientific studies, whether it is overlapping or not. So that is a difference like that, because we, when I was in Cambodia, so we had done a complete study on flora and fauna was studying, because they couldn't even find out whether it is Siamese or whether it is salt water. So they have to do a DNA study. So these are conditions sometimes we arise to completely tell this is a right species.
Right. Thank you, Beju sir. The next question is, where can we find gharials? Are they very rare to spot?
Yes, gharials can be now found in Uttar Pradesh. If you are talking, we have Katarniya Ghat. You can find gharial. You can find in Chambal rivers. A good population of gharials are there. In 2007, I had worked. There was a catastrophe happened with the gharials. Around 105 gharials died because of pesticides and this from the marginal cultivation happened. So most of the residues from mercury and this poisoning, and they were dying off. That is how I started first working with gharial in 2007. And 110, I was helping to do postmortem for overnight 20-30 postmortems. So gharials you can find very nicely. If somebody want to see in Chambal, you can go and see now. Now they have a very good stable population of gharials.
Right. Thank you, Beju sir. The next question is, sir, how do we safely rescue king cobras? There are a lot of videos that surface where the king cobra is very difficult to tackle or to get into a snake bag. What to do at that time?
Who is this asking? Is a rescuer or?
Someone, not a rescuer, just a comment.
Okay. So I had only rescued one king cobra because I had not spent much time in Kerala. That was in a big tank. It was, I went inside, I kept a bag and touched the king cobra. King cobra went in. I had not even handled the king cobra. So I try maximum to do that, because when you handle any snake, it is always good to not handle snake. So what happened is snake will be always fresh to release. Once you hold head and all, king cobra, it is there on one video on my, I don't know, if you want, I can share. My brother is doing so many king cobra calls because he stays in Kerala and he get many calls. So it is very easy to handle king cobra according to me, because they are very, very calm snake. They never bite you unless and until you provoke them. Otherwise, if you handle them very gently, put it near the bag, it will go on its own. It is very, 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 very gentle snake, because king cobra know that if king cobra bite anybody, they will not survive. So king cobra will not try to bite anybody. That I believe.
Right, sir.
It's very, very easy to handle a king cobra compared to other small snakes. So we have to be very careful. Mm-hmm. Having said that, we have to be very careful, but we can handle it very gently. If that person can send us an email or something, I can send him some video of very easy rescues of king cobras.
Sure, sir. So another question that we have is, what can we do as common people to restore our environment to save the reptiles?
Common people only can do. Whatever they can do is they only can do. Everything they can do. If he or she found a snake in his house, they have to just send us a picture if possible. So if it is a rat snake, or if you try to identify, if it is a rat snake, please leave it there. What I had done, I had now slowly working on a different issue altogether. Where you see snakes, if now many studies are going of replacing, like if you move some dogs from one place, some other dogs will come into that place. Like that, if you move some species of snakes from your house, so if it is a good area, very many rats are available, so other snakes can move into that area. So if you have a rat snake in your backyard, it is always keep or leave that rat snake as it is. So what happens is other snakes moving into that area will be very, very minimal. So as a person, keep your environment clean, keep your house inside clean, or what you call adjoining to the house clean, because wherever you keep something more, what happens is there are possibility of rats going inside and snakes crawling inside. That is why we encounter snakes most of the time. Otherwise, if it is house a little away, it is clean, means there is no problem. And if you want to protect your environment, make it like environmentally friendly, not so much clean, so much cutting grass, everything, and leave some spaces where animals can survive. That's what they can do. And try not to maximum call rescue and eliminate all the species like a monitor lizard, calotus, or rat snake, or sand boa from your place. We have to understand that we had lived with these species from generation and generation. Because of our development activities, we are able to see them. A snake comes out only when it is hungry. Otherwise, snake is already there. When it is hungry, it is coming out to, in search of some food. That is why we encounter a snake. So we can always protect your nearby area. So it will automatically be protected. You don't have to do much work on that area.
Right, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Last question is, what is your opinion on how to tackle snakes that are killed in road kills?
See, why snakes are killed in road accident is a very interesting thing, because we don't know why they are traveling. One is what you know, because of the cold, sometimes it will be very cold in the forested area, they will go on the road to get warm. So we cannot help it. We don't know how to, the vehicle, the driver have to stop it. Otherwise, what happens, runover will happen. And one of the other issues of this road kills are, because we are going and releasing the species, because I told about the rescuers, they rescue from the city and release everywhere, wherever they find. And there are places where only 10 rat snake can survive. If you introduce 50 rat snake in that same area, some rat snake have to move out. There is competition over resources. This is what maximum road kills are happening. So this is one of the very, very important factor you have to keep it in mind. Please don't release snakes in an area which you don't know. You have to know that area, whether snake can survive, and then release there. Please don't go and release everything into one area. I had seen many of the social media videos. I had seen 50 snakes, 60 snakes, people are going and releasing in one area. What will happen to those snakes? We have to be very, very, very much think about this. 50 snakes, 60 snakes are dumped in one. I had seen myself. You can just Google, you can see that videos. There are many YouTube videos. 50 snakes have been released in one area. Snakes have to move out. There is a competition. But these snakes you had caught from point A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and all had been released in one area. So these are one of the things we have to be very, very careful. And this is going to be increase only. It is not going to be reduced. So the rescuer, the person who is calling, all these are responsible for this. So rescuers are fully responsible releasing snakes wherever they want.
Thank you so much for the wonderful presentation, Beju sir. Thank you again, everyone, for your time and consideration. A very special thank you to BNHS for this wonderful collaboration. Have a good day. Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody.